Hi everyone, this is Dimitri Pragmatic with MarketChameleon.com. Right now I wanted to discuss one of the most important things you would need to succeed in trading options, and that is an edge. An edge is some kind of an advantage, and we're going to talk about right now a statistical edge, because options themselves, they are instruments of probability. It's an option is the probability of something happening out into the future, an unknown. And when we look at options, that's what we do, is use our statistics and our data to figure out how the markets are lining up and are the odds currently in our favor. So I brought up here in SPY, so I went to the SPY, and I'm looking at some of these trading cards that are filtering out from our screeners that are looking for opportunities for certain strategies that have an edge. So let's just take this first one over here, a bull put spread. And we see here that it's looking at the November 15th put spread. It's selling the 291 put over here, strike, and buying the 288 put. So this is a credit put spread. We're selling the higher strike, buying the lower strike for a credit price of 47 cents. Here we see that we calculated using the last 6 years of data that the theoretical value of this spread is 27 cents. And what this is saying is that based on 6 years of historical data, if you did a similar option strategy of same days to expiration, strikes same distance away from the current stock price, that at expiration, on average, the end value was 27 cents. In other words, if you did this spread over and over and over again, sometimes it was higher, sometimes it was lower, but on average, the end value is 27 cents. So the edge would be if you would have sold it for 47 cents each time and were able to buy back for 27 cents, that would have resulted in a 20 cent profit. And based on how much you were risking, so over here, you're collecting 47 cents. Of course, this is a $3 put spread. So if SPY drops below that strike at expiration, anything below that expiration, then you have to buy that put spread back for $3 minus the 47 cents. So that's your risk, $2.53, and 20 cents edge divided by 253. That gives you your percentage edge over here. So I'm going to give another example of edge. You see here, this edge is explained in percentage terms, and this is your win rate. And these two things are important. Sometimes people look only at win rate and imagine, well, that, you know, I just want a high win rate and that's my edge, but that's not necessarily true. Sometimes you could have a high win rate, but your expected return is negative. So let's look at an example of edge in something more simple. And I created this over here in my paint here. And let's just take this scenario. Let's imagine that you have a coin flip, you know, heads or tails, and somebody really wants to bet on heads, and they have to find somebody to take that wager, to take the other side. And let's pretend that not only he wants to bet on heads, but there are a lot of people who all of a sudden see this trend and think that the next coin flip is going to land on heads. So since now we have an imbalance, right, and everybody wants to bet on heads, somebody to entice you have to pay somebody to take the other side. And let's just pretend that now this person who wants to bet on heads, he's willing to, that if it lands on heads, you pay him $1. However, if it lands on tails, you get $1.10. So you see here, this created incentive. The market imbalance created an incentive for somebody to take the other side of this coin flip, this bet. So let's see what your edge is and what your win rate is, your expected win rate and your expected edge. So over here, I painted, and let's just pretend that over time, the more times you flip, heads, tails, it'll be 50-50. Okay, so I just did an example here of 10 flips, but really, it's laws of large numbers. The more you flip, the closer it gets to 50-50. But let's just pretend over here we did 10 flips instead of 100 flips to make this demonstration a little bit simpler. And let's pretend, you know, the first flip, you lost, you pay him a dollar. Second flip, you lost, you pay him a dollar. Third flip, you won, he pays you $1.10. Fourth, you won, he pays you $1.10. And so you could see how this, I lined this up, 10 flips, and I made them even. Five times, you lost, so you would lose $1 five times. Five times, you won, and you would make $1.10 five times. So if you added all those up, your net result is a profit of 50 cents, right? You lost $5, you won $5.50. So you net profited 50 cents. So what is your edge for doing this trade? So you risk $10, right? Because you did the trade 10 times, each time you risked a dollar and you made 50 cents. So over here, let's just take a look at this. Over here, this is your edge. You made 50 cents, right? You risk $10, that's a 5% edge. In other words, what you're expect for every dollar you risk, you're expecting to make 5% edge over a long period of time. That's your average return over a long period of time. Your win rate here, right, is you won 5 out of 10, 50%. So you could see here your win rate is 50-50, but you still have an edge because of that payoff. The expected long-term return gives you a statistical edge. Just like a casino, just like an insurance company, you're looking for a mathematical or statistical advantage to take the other side of the bet. And that's what we talk about for traders. For them to be successful, you need to find an edge and be able to quantify that edge. And that makes it easier for you to make a good trading decision. Of course, if you're certain that the next spin or the next coin flip is going to be heads, then you shouldn't take the bet. Then you should bet on heads if you're certain 100%. But if you don't know, then these are the odds, right? If you don't know, it's going to be either heads or tails, and you have this mathematical advantage and you believe it's still 50-50, then that's your edge to take the other side of the bet. And that's what we have over here. Coming back to these trade cards, that's your edge, your expected long-term return. So here you are making an assumption that the historical price return distributions based on history, you know, will look very similar going forward. And, you know, and based on that model, that would be your expected edge and historical win rate. Of course, you know, just like an insurance company, history, you know, may not dictate exactly how the future will be, but it has been a good guidance. So that's what we're looking at. This one happens to be a 90% historical win rate with an 8% edge. And you could see here, if you sell it above a theoretical value, obviously you want, if you're selling, receiving a credit, you want to sell it above. If you're buying something, like for example, if you're buying a call spread or you're buying a put spread for debit, you want to be buying it below to get that edge. So that's a really quick overview of this card and what it means. And then once, if you want to go in there deeper and look at the data, you just click over here. It will take you to the options chain, and then you could go in there and open up and look at the data, historical data, and do more evaluation or change some other parameters if you'd like. So, and I'll explain that in another video. Hopefully this was helpful, and excited to see you in the next video. Thanks, everyone.